All right, let's say you get to the middle of the day, you're starting to feel a little sluggish. You're like me, you probably reach for another cup of coffee. Dr. Oz says not so much. Maybe even some stretches can kind of wake you up.
Stretches help a lot. Let's start with a basic stretch of the diaphragm. The diaphragm is the muscle beneath our lungs.
Okay.
So, let me go up behind you. Take a deep breath.
Okay.
Okay, oh, stop right there. You see how she did it? Deirdre brought her chest out, but her stomach did not go out. That's not how you take a deep breath in. Breathe
okay.
Your head. So what you want to do is turn sideways. We get an angle here. So you can take a count of four. Everyone at home, please do this just once. Trust me, it's worth it. Most important stress reduction exercise. On four, you're going to breathe out. Push your stomach out as you inhale.
Okay.
It's a belly breath. As you exhale, let the stomach fall flaccid and pull the belly button towards the spine in order to push the diaphragm up. Okay?
Okay.
Deep breath in. We'll do it together.
Okay,
ready?
So you go out first.
Like that, right. One, two, three. Way up. Hold it, everybody. Five. Let it go. Six. Relax. Seven. Now pull your belly button towards your spine. Okay? Eight. One more time in. One, two. Push your stomach out. Three, four. Exhale. Five, six. Really pull your belly button. Seven. Eight. Now, that's a deep breath. That works because it sucks nitric oxide, not nitrous oxide for the partiers out there, nitric oxide from the sinuses down into the lungs. It opens up the lungs so you can get more air down there. Second exercise.
Yeah,
very
I've never
simple.
Breathed like that before.
Big places where we hold our tension is our hips and our jaws. So let's do the hips first. You take a deep breath, reach forward, and just touch your feet if you can. Nothing special, nothing magical. But here's the deal. You want to not just stretch your hamstrings. You want your hips to relax as you go down. So think about that. Think of the hips actually letting go as you slowly fall further and further and further towards the ground. Now, once you've done those basic stretches, then I want you to do two other ones. I want you to get a chair that you're sitting in normally. Don't sit down in it, though. And you're going to pretend you're sitting down. So you go down. Just when you're about to touch it, you go back up again. Go down. Just when you're about to touch it, you go back up again. Down. Just about to touch it. Go back up. And then the last thing you're going to do...
There's really no reason why Walt and Dirk couldn't be doing this right now, is there?
They conspired ahead of time. Cowards. And the last one is put your arms on the side of the chair. Keep your knees bent. You don't go down to a relaxed position so your bottom is almost at the ground. Then go back up again.
That feels good.
Yeah, same thing. It stretches out the upper body as well. So these actually combine a little bit of exercise of the muscles because they warm up. But as you warm up, you're also able to get deeper and stretch out the ligaments. There's one last joint we have to exercise. The jaw. It's the only joint we have that actually comes out of joint when you move it.
Mm-hmm.
And because of that, you store a lot of tension here. So I got this. Dr. Tom, here's yours.
Okay, I get my own.
Go.
Now, in theory, you drink the bottle of wine first. We'll get to that later.
In theory, we did. This came from my house.
So you take the cork.
Right.
This is very effective when you're driving, actually, because people won't bother you when you do this. And you let the cork relax your jaw, like this. And what it does is it allows the muscle to relax and the jaw joint pulls apart. The other nice thing is when you're driving, as I said, makes you look a little different from everybody else.
Indeed. And is that a good thing?
It's a good thing because people don't talk to you that way. And that also can calm you down. But this is a very simple little trick that is, again, based on some of these ancient Ayurvedic techniques that just pulls the joints apart. And as you do it, as you relax your head on your jaw, this entire part of your head just all of a sudden lets go. And a lot of the tension, headaches, the anxiety, the frustration that we hold in our jaw joint, when you clench your teeth like that, it all goes away. I also do it at night because I tend to grind my teeth at night, and a lot of folks do that. Relax the jaw ahead of time. It lets the sleep process proceed more effortlessly.
And don't people who have jaw issues tend to get headaches too, Dr. Tom?
Absolutely.
Is that pretty common?
Yeah, it is. Especially when you're talking about the tension along the jaw, TMJ. Some people also have a problem with TMJ, and that pain it radiates up into the, they may have temporal pain as well, and be a cause of their headache syndrome. Yeah.
Interesting. Yeah. All right. And you get to have the wine as well.
The good thing about the wine, let me just bring this up real quick. The red wine is a little better than the white wine is that red wine has the skin of the grape in it. The skin of the grape has something called resveratrol, which is a chemical that the wine was able to absorb because the grapes were struggling as they were growing, right? They grow on a hilly terrain. It's dry. It's arid. The plant kingdom is saying, hey, wait a minute. There's a famine going on out there. We want to make sure the mammals live longer. So they actually signal us to live longer. And that's why, unfortunately, you need about 100 bottles a day. But in pill form, resveratrol given to laboratory animals seems to prolong longevity. So I'm very excited, not about the resveratrol itself, but the fact that we are very close to unlocking the key to longevity. And imagine if you could live to age 120 to 130 without the kinds of morbidity and weakness and frailty that so often happens to us. It would be a wonderful thing, I think, for a lot of us to at least consider for our future.
Thank you.
All right. Do you drink red wine every day?
I don't drink red wine every day because I usually am so busy. If I drank red wine, I'd pass out. But I do. but when I drink alcohol, I drink red wine.
You go for the red. All right, thanks. Well, all of our clips with Dr. Oz can be seen on KCRA.com. Just look under the As Seen On section. And then we've also got a link to your website, Dr. Oz. And it's a great place to go if you have a question really about anything. And you've got things categorized from A to B. Think of an ailment. You've probably got an answer for it. And it's on there. And you can also submit a question to your staff, too, and it'll be answered by a true medical professional.
And if I want to give a shout out to medical professionals in the Sacramento area, we want you to participate. We're just trying to harvest the collective IQ of all the healers in America. People have got good ideas. And if you had an illness and recovered from it, you're the world expert in that problem. You know more than I do about it, for sure, because you lived through it. Those are the stories we want to hear on the Dr. Oz Show.
If you want to be on the show as a guest, just let them know. There's a thing you can fill out there. All right, we will be back right after this. You know the Cork.
Oh,
you're okay.
Doc, great honor.
Hey, nice to be here.
Thanks for having me on.
You bet.
Yeah.
Thank you.